Hello, welcome in my channel. So today I'm going to start the pointer part 6. Okay, so in the previous part 5 we discussed a few exams like this. Okay, so I hope you don't have any confusion in this example. So today what is our agenda? Today I'm going to discuss about what types of pointer, little bit I already discussed. So what is the default value of pointer, and several pointers pointing to the same location in RAM, and size of pointer variable. So discussing one by one, but I'm expecting all of you have covered the part 5. Okay, only then you can understand the future topic. So types of pointers, once again just a briefing, we can say pointer to integer, or in short pointer to int, or also you can say what, integer pointer. Integer pointer. Second, first one I am taking pointer to character, or simply pointer to char, or you can say character pointer. Okay, next one the same way, second one pointer to integer, or pointer to int, or you can say integer pointer. Yes, next one, next one you can say pointer to float, or you can say floating point pointer. Next one, you can say pointer to double, or you can say double point. Double point. I don't understand means I have to discuss these points already. You know this one. I already in the previous section I described each and every points. Once again, what do you mean by pointer to character? Means each and every pointer variable contains the address, and at that address you have how many bytes of information. Here also I am commenting like it is more beneficial to you. What is the remarks here? Pointer to character or character pointer? Means at that address, okay, you have one byte of information. One byte of information we have at that address. In the same case, what in the second one, a pointer to integer or integer pointer, means you have either 2 or 4 byte of information. Two or four byte of information at that address. In this case, in case of pointer to float, means pointer contains address at that address, how much information you have? 4 byte of information you have. 4 byte at that address. Okay, and last one, in this case, we have 8 byte of information. Okay, so means already I discussed about the dereferencing word. Dereferencing such pointer means what? It is useful. Already I discussed what means why it is necessary to supply the base type in the declaration statement of pointer. So this that was the answer already I described in the previous lecture. Means at the time of dereferencing, total how many byte of information system should fetch? Okay, so 1 byte or 2 or 4 byte in case of int, 4 byte information is fetched in case of the float pointer, and 8 byte of information is fetched in case of the double pointer. Okay, so this is clear. Now I am going to discuss about the next one. What is the topic is what? Default value of pointer. So see here, we have so many cases. Means what? We have the global pointers. We have the local pointers. We may have what? Again, we have the varieties here. What? General global pointer and global static pointer. Local general local pointer, and also we have the what? Local static pointer. So here I am writing. So I may have also what? Global static. A static pointer. Also I may have local a static pointer. Next one, I may have what? Automatic pointer. Okay, so many cases. I am not discussing the word global and local here. Just remember in this case what till now we have taken so many examples. Means that is what? Means I have defined the pointers within the function, within the main. Okay, so etc. Just this time just focus all of you, automatic pointer variable. Okay, so what is automatic pointer variable? What is automatic pointer variable? Declared within any function without a static keyword. Okay, so in all the above case, what it is generally in a slice to the null. Remember this one. in all above case except automatic pointer. Okay, it takes null, but here it takes garbage value. So this is the reason, means as a programmer, it is our responsibility to initialize such automatic pointer variable. So it's our responsibility to initialize such pointer immediately. Just after declare. Okay, so remember this one. In the above case, okay, means it is not necessary to initialize, because by default it takes null. Okay, but only in case of the automatic pointer variable, it is our responsibility to initialize. Okay, so fine. And again, so I discussed about the types of pointer. I discussed about what is the default value of the pointer. This is the interview question. So remember this one. Which I explained. Now, taking the another example, what several pointers pointing to the same location in RAM. One more thing here. What do you mean by if pointer takes the null? Concept of null in pointer. See here, if any pointer contains some address, that is fine. Means at that address we have some information, but it contains null. What is the meaning of this one, and what is the benefit of such one? So let me explain this one. If any pointer contains garbage value, what is the meaning of this one? Means garbage value, we have the some information, some address, so it points to some other location in RAM. Okay, so dereferencing search, we will get some unpredictable value. Okay, so this is the problem. That's why we must initialize it. We must assign address immediately. Okay. Okay. Sometimes I may forget to assign the address in the pointer. So in that case, as I discussed, it contains the garbage value, and at that garbage value, you may have some information in the RAM. So when you try to dereference such pointer, definitely you will not get the perfect information, perfect result. Okay, okay. So if also you can do what we can also mention. We can also set null to it so that means I have what certainty that such pointer is not pointing to some other location, that is it is not pointing to the unpredictable value, so that we should never get unpredictable value. It is also the good practice. Okay, now if your pointer contains null, then what is the meaning of this one? Means obviously in case of pointer having null, it ensures us not pointing to other location. Okay, so I hope this is sufficient information about this one. Next one I am going to discuss about, already I discussed which one, types of pointer, default value of pointer. Now I am going to discuss about several pointers pointing to the same location in RAM. So this is the topic. So I am stopping this one. In the next lecture I will clarify this concept, these two concepts, several pointers pointing to same location and size of the pointer value. Okay, meeting you in the next lecture. Thank you.